remote desktop protocol used to be one of those cases where a FIDO2 security key could not be used. But thanks to recent updates by Microsoft, including the introduction of the RDP AAD protocol, we can now use a FIDO2 security key, not just within an RDP session, but also to authenticate the session itself. Now, for this to work, a few different things needs to be true. Number one, our session host, that is the host we are connecting to, it needs to be either Windows 10, Windows 11, Windows Server 2019, or Windows Server 2022. It also needs to be Azure joined or Azure hybrid joined. The host we're connecting from, the local host, needs to be, again, Windows 10, Windows 11, or Windows Server 2019, or Windows Server 2022. This host, however, does not need to be Azure joined. Lastly, our connecting user needs to be a hybrid Azure user or a cloud-native Azure user. Importantly, this user must be added to the remote desktop users group on the session host, and it needs to be added given its Azure AD context. Let's look at the configuration here for FIDO2. The first thing here is we need to address the server by name. I'm also providing my username as a UPN. And then on the advanced tab, we need to check web account. From there, we can just hit connect or enter. Azure will now prompt me to select, or it will present my user account. The FIDO2 authentication sequence will be user verification, prompt for PIN, the knowledge factor, followed by user presence, which in a sense it proves the possession factor, but also proves that there's a real live human initiating the authentication sequence. So there you go. One thing to be aware of here is that if you're using a web account, you will have SSO, or you will have a rather long-lived session unless you configure Azure otherwise. So I'm reconnecting here without re-authenticating. If you cannot meet these requirements, or for whatever reason you do not wish to meet these requirements, a security key such as the YubiKey, it still has you covered. The YubiKey can act as a smart card, and this has a number of benefits over a traditional form factor smart card. For one, we can do away with requirements on smart card readers. And two, we can use it over NFC, so we can connect and do certificate-based authentication on tablets and smartphones. The YubiKey, by the way, is currently the only certificate-based authenticator supported by Microsoft for Microsoft native mobile apps and for mobile web apps federated to Azure. Let's also look at certificate-based authentication. So again, I'm addressing the server or the remote host by name. I'm providing my username, still as a UPN here, could do otherwise. And I'm unchecking the web account selection made earlier. From there, provided we have a smart card logon certificate enrolled on the YubiKey, we go ahead and connect. It will prompt for the knowledge path factor, which is a 6-digit PIN. And that will have me connect over RDP to the session host. So it's a great choice for RDP, and it's a great choice for almost everything else.